We're here at the National Monster Truck Show. We're having a great time, so everybody get ready to see the Monster Truck Show. We're about to go in national, and we're about to really get some action. So everybody have a great time. Woohoo! Rock on!
Welcome, Monster Truck fans, to the first annual Monster Truck Challenge event. We're here at Gateway International Raceway in St. Louis, Missouri. We're on the Illinois side of the river, but hey, it's all St. Louis. You can see the arch right on the other side of the grandstands there. Hey, this is Kyle Doyle with the Monster Blog. I got Colby Marshall on video today. We are stoked to be here. We've got what is really the premier outdoor event in this area of the country today. As you can see, we've got a really crazy figure eight track coming together out here. Don't even ask me how it's going to work. The drivers don't even know. That's how exciting it's going to be. The track crew is still thrashing on the racetrack. We received over a couple inches of additional rain last night. That's going to hurt us a little bit right now. The ambient temperature outside is over 90 degrees. Right here on the track, it's got to be even hotter. We're sweating like crazy out here. But we're hoping Mother Nature helps us out a little bit, throws a little heat down there and gets that mud baked out of there. It stinks like wet mud out here. It is terrible. It kind of smells like Colby when he doesn't have his shoes on. But no, we're doing all right down here. As you can see, we've got a massive freestyle stack with a bus over here. We've got a mystery stack over here. We got two cars, two vans, nothing in the middle. We're told the Monster Truck Challenge guys have a surprise for us there, so we'll have to see what that entails. To lay down the Monster Truck track for you a little bit, we're going to start over there on the red and yellow roller hills. They're going to come over those hills through no man's land there. Over the massive dirt jump in the center, they're going to clear this small roller of a tabletop. Then this is where it starts getting tricky. The trucks are going to actually head up onto the banking of Gateway International Raceway. The first time ever, they're going to be on the banking. They're going to hook a hard left turnaround side by side, come back over these two sets of cars here, back in the infield, over the small tabletop roller again, and then back on to Gateway International Raceway one more time, up on the banking, and they're going to finish back down the part of the track they started on, over the two-car roller, through a long no-man's land run, and over that final jump right there. As you can see, that final jump is way bigger than a normal car jump would be. We're expecting to see some massive air off of that. It's going to be a crazy night on track. We've got 10 of the best monster trucks in the country here. Looking at racing, you got to call Mark Hall and Jimmy Creighton. That could be the matchup of the night. That is worth the price of admission alone right there. Jimmy Creighton, he's been dominant on the Monster Truck Challenge Tour this year. And hey, Mark Hall, you can't count him out on any kind of track. Should be really interesting. We got Dan Runney, a multi-time champion himself in the Summit Bigfoot. He's going to be trying hard for the hometown win in racing. In freestyle, you couldn't hardly ask for a better lineup in freestyle. We got Jim Kohler, the brand new Avenger. Steve Kohler, his brother, going to be running the Brutus body on the old Avenger chassis. You've got a proven freestyler in a new truck, and you've got a new up-and-coming young gun in a proven freestyle truck. Mike Hawkins, they got both of their trucks. Hot Tamale and Equalizer are going to be here. And hey, Devin Jones and Barbarian. Saw him run 2 weeks ago in New Orleans. Very impressed. He can run in any environment. He made a splash last year. I think he's going to do even better. He's looking to go big tonight. He's actually becoming a little later in the freestyle order tonight. We're looking for big things from Devin. We're going to take you down here on the track in a bit, and throughout the night, I'll be announcing, along with George Eisenhart from the Monster Nationals, we'll be handling the mic duties. Colby's going to be on video. We're going to be bringing you complete coverage, along with Ross Bonar of the Monster Blog, of this, the first annual Monster Truck Challenge here at Gateway International. All right, we're here on the front stretch with Raminator driver Mark Hall. Mark, we just got done with the driver's meeting. They're making some changes to the track. It's a long ways from finished. What do you think about this track?
Well, Kyle, I don't know. It's going to be a long ways around here. It's going to be fast. You know, it's a long track, but there's not a whole lot of obstacles in it. So it should be really, really fast. You know, the turns are going to be interesting because it looks like we're going to kind of go up here on the asphalt track a little bit and use some of their banking and stuff. So, you know, that'll be kind of interesting. I think it's one of those deals we're going to have to go slow to go fast through the turns and I don't know. It'll be interesting. It'll be a lot of fun, I think.
All right. One of the trickiest things for a monster truck, obviously, is going from asphalt to dirt and back to it, and then we got grass on top of that. That's probably going to be the most critical point of the track, don't you think, tonight?
I think so, especially with all the rain and stuff they've had here. The track guys have done a great job with, you know, with what they had to work with and stuff. They've done really good. Yeah, we're going from dirt to asphalt, across asphalt, back to dirt. You know, it's going to be interesting. The starting line, one guy's starting on asphalt, one guy's starting on dirt, so that, you know, that's going to be interesting, too, see how that works out. But you know, all in all, it should make for some interesting racing, some fun racing. So, you know, we'll see. Hopefully we'll be talking to you at the end of the night, maybe from Victory Lane.
All right, one of the big storylines this weekend, Tim's in Canfield, Ohio, to another event, so you're without your normal crew chief. You know, we saw you on the phone. What kind of tune-ups are you guys working on over the phone? And, you know, you guys have a lot of tires at your disposal. What have you brought for tires this weekend to kind of deal with this, you know, mixed bag of goodies here?
Well, we brought our digging tires, you know, the ones that are cut for racing in the mud. I think we're gonna get out on the asphalt, but for the most part we're in the dirt, so we're gonna need some good digging tires. And yeah, I just got off the phone with Tim and I kind of stepped it off and told him what I come up with, and so he gave me some input on what kind of gearing to run and stuff like that. So you know, we're gonna go with his advice in qualifying, and usually he's pretty darn close on all that sort of thing, so we'll go with what he says, and like I say, hopefully it'll work out.
All right, now we got to talk about this. Jimmy Creighton and Bounty Hunters here. The fans, that's all they're talking about this year. We want to see Mark Hall race Jimmy Creighton. Two big guns in racing. You guys really don't ever get to meet up that much. It's been a long time. So, I mean, are you looking forward to lining up against him on a big track like this in the dirt instead of just on asphalt?
Oh, absolutely. You know, Jimmy's a great racer. He's got a good piece there. They got a good team over there. So, you know, he's a great racer. And yeah, I think the last time we ran with him was it was a couple years ago at Montreal or something. So, yeah, it's been a long time. It'll be fun. You know, I got a lot of respect for those guys. And, yeah, I watch him on TV there. I know how good he is. So he does a great job. It'll be fun racing with him. It'll be fun racing with all these guys. You know, there's some really good iron here. So, you know, anybody can win this deal on any given night. So it'll be fun. It'll be cool. And, heck, yeah, whoever we line up with is going to be good.
All right, guys, we appreciate your time. We'll be talking to you a little more tonight. And like you said, who knows, it may even be in Victory Lane. So that's all from down here on the front stretch from Mark Hall. We're going to go catch up with some of the other guys here in a little bit. All right, we showed you the view of the track from the front stretch a little bit earlier. Now we're standing at the big freestyle stack we were getting a look at with the bus in it. You saw the massive chunk missing out of the ramp there. At the last minute, we just finished the driver's meeting. The Monster Truck Challenge officials, with the consent of the entire field of Monster Truck drivers, they're actually going to go ahead and steepen up these ramps we're standing on here for the bus stack. As you can see, they got everything built up on a pad of dirt. And as you can hear, they're blaring the country music here by Broken Bro record artists. But they're actually going to steepen up these ramps on here a little bit. There's been a concern at some of the Monster Truck Challenge events prior to this one that these ramps actually have too much of a grade to them, and the trucks have been launching off of them, but the rear tires have been clipping these buses and sending the guys into a bit of a nosedive. Mark Hall, Jimmy Creighton, and Mike Hawkins had all expressed some concerns about this in the past. Brian Manson and Ryan Seaton have addressed that. They're going to go ahead and steepen these ramps up a little bit. Brian Braunschweig's probably going to be a little upset. He's got to repaint them all again, but they'll get it looking good. They'll be ready for showtime, and we might even see some bigger air off of these later. So we better get out of the way now, because here come the dirt guys.